presented by Church Tech U and the ProPresenter 7 Magic Keyboard Skin. It's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, how to put props, different props, on different screens in ProPresenter 7. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Alan Clifford. And before we get started, if you've ever had a situation where you wanted one prop on one screen and another prop on another screen, but not both on both screens, go ahead, subscribe, give me a like, and hit the little bell icon while you're at it. So, credit where credit's due. I went to SALT 2021 this past October, and there's so much to know that even though I wasn't teaching any classes, I thought that I would sit in on Brad Zimmerman's class. And he put forth a hack to show videos on multiple screens at the same time. I've done something similar, but his way was a little bit different. And that got me thinking, could I use his hack to put props on different screens? And the answer is yes. Yes, you can. So let's head over to my computer and I'll show you exactly what I'm talking about. So here we are in Pro 7. And the very first thing that we need to do is we need to figure out a way to separate out different props on different screens. How could we do that? Well, what if we used the hack that I told you about, well, it's been over a year ago now, for showing, deciding between whether you want information on spanned across screens or tiled across screens, which used to be a checkbox in Pro 6, but here's another way to do it. So, in Pro 7, let's go to Screens and then Configure Screens. You'll notice that I have four screens. I've got my main out, my alpha, my portrait monitor, which is this guy right here, and my live stream. So, main, alpha, portrait, live. Main, alpha, portrait, live. I'm going to remember that. And you'll see why here in just a second. Now, I'm going to, even though these are all four separate devices, what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the plus button here, and I'm going to add a new display. And that display needs to be a grouped display. So I'm going to click grouped here, and I'm going to call this quad. Now I could, if I only had two screens coming out, I could have just two. If I had three, I could do like three wide, whatever. But since I've got the four here, the main, the alpha, the portrait, and the live, I'm going to do that. So first off, I'm going to right click on this and call this quad, just so that it's clear that this is different. Now, the first one up here, let's assign this to main out. So I'm going to go up here and actually, I can't remember which one my main out was. So that is the BMD on the right. Okay, so go up here. And that's this guy. And it's going to squawk at me. And I want to select assign to all so that it can do both. So assign to all. Done. Okay, alpha is the second one. So let's put that here. And that is my Decklink Duo 1 at 2997. So I'm going to do that. Again, it says, hey, do you want to reassign this? No, I want it on both. So I'm going to do that. So, and just to double check, Decklink Duo 1 is there and Decklink Duo 1 is there. Next, I'm going to select this one, and that's my portrait monitor. So let's check which one the portrait monitor is. That's the DeckLink Duo 2. Okay, so let's select DeckLink Duo 2. And same thing, assign to all. And the last one is the live stream. Which one is the live stream? It's actually a siphon out. So let's select that, select this, and it's this one, again, assigned to all. So, oh, for some reason that didn't take. Let me go back here to DeckLink Duo 2 and select that and assign to all. Okay. Oh, I see what I did. I accidentally clicked up here. You probably noticed that. So I'm going to go back here and fix that. That was this one, assigned to all. So now, just to double check, my main out here is the Blackmagic HDMI on the right-hand side. Notice it'll have this little warning because it's assigned to multiple things. You'll see that on all of them. This, hey, you're assigned to multiple things. See? That's what, if you leave the mouse there, it tells you what that warning is about. So that's DeckLink Duo 1, DeckLink Duo 1, DeckLink Duo 2 should be the portrait monitor, and it is, and this last one is Siphon 1, that has that, so Siphon 1. Okay, so the reason I chose to put them where they are, and you'll see that this has already done some funkiness to my portrait monitor here, is because it's easier to remember. If I would remember it more easily going 1, 2, 3, 4 instead of 1, 2, 3, 4, I could have done that. If for some reason I remember things in odd configurations, I could reassign them all sorts of weird ways. So that's step one. Step two, now that we've got that done, let's fix this by going into Screens, Edit Looks, and notice the quad here is showing everything. For our normal look, we want it to show nothing. So I'm just going to go through. When I uncheck this, I expect that that would disappear. There we go. There and there. So I'm going to save that as it is, just to make sure that's the normal way. Okay, nothing special with this unchecked in all my looks. It's as if I haven't done a thing. But if I want to create a prop that, let's say, one of them goes to my main out and one of them goes to my alpha out, then I'm going to create another look. So I'm going to add a preset here. Let's call this main. Let's first learn how to spell main and alpha prop. Okay. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to uncheck everything but props in the quad area, and make sure that the prop is unchecked in main and alpha and portrait and live. So now I can only get my props from the quad out here. So let me make that live. Actually, I don't want announcements on any of these except for my portrait monitor as well. Yeah, I think that'll do what I want it to do. So that's good to go. Now I'm going to make this live. Okay. Now I can go down here and let's add a prop, shall we? So, sorry, I was just toggling off my picture-in-picture. So let's go to the props. Okay. And let me add a prop. And let's call this main prop. And let's add another one, and I'll call that alpha prop. L-P-H-A-P-R-O-P. Okay? So now, if I right-click and I go to edit, I'm going to go ahead and use these guidelines here. So it should be like 1920. Because all four of my screens are, they're all 1080p. And then I'm going to add one right here. So this should be about 1080 down. You might be starting to see what's going on here. So now, that's not perfect. I could take a moment and get these exactly perfect, but this is close enough for our purposes. So now, down here in the main prop, which is the one that I want, remember it was main, alpha, portrait, live. Anything I put here is only going to show up on the main screen with that particular look enabled. So let's add something. Let's add a shape just for giggles. A triangle. Okay, right now it would show up on all four screens, but when I drag it here in the middle, it's going to show on the main screen. Okay, now let's go here to shape, and I'm going to add a star and put that in the upper right hand corner. And this could be anything that you could add on the props layer would do that. So it really doesn't matter all that much which I what I put here. It could be an image, it could be a video, whatever. Right now, when I put this prop in, both of these are going to show up at the same time, one on one screen, one on the other. But I could also, here, let me get that. I could also do it kind of exactly the opposite. And I'm not going to drag these guidelines because I'm just going to put it up in the upper right hand corner. So let's put our star here and put it in the upper right hand corner, which the right hand quadrant is the alpha. So now I can put in the main by itself, and I can put in the alpha by itself, and I can take them out individually. So let me show you what that looks like. So now if I were to looks like we've got let's clear out all our props here. And now if I go down to the quad, the previewing is a little odd, but think of this as the quad version. So I go here and notice that's in the upper left hand corner. If I were to bring the thing full screen, since this is transparent, it would show up over my main output. The alpha here, I can actually show this to you since you're looking at my screen. So I just need to put the key on for my my alpha screen, and let me actually do this. I'm gonna have that going. So if I go to alpha, you can see this is what it would look like without the props layer, because remember in the looks menu, we disabled the props layer for this. But if I go down to the quad, we have this showing up in the upper right hand corner. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put my key on right here, and we should see this taking up full screen, and this in the upper right-hand corner. This is just for preview's sake. Yours won't be like this because you wouldn't want to overtake your main user interface. So let me do just that. This is the one. There we go. So you'll see that it is in fact there on the full screen, and it's only showing the one prop even though both props are active. So if I wanted to show both of those props on a third screen, then I could go into edit looks and I could tweak that and make it to where edit looks showed, I could make it to where edit, using the edit looks dialog, that preset showed both on one. So in fact, let me do that. So we'll go to the, I'm going to just go down to the live here. So we see live. Now if I go into screens and edit looks, if I enable props, it should show both the one in the middle and the one in the upper right-hand corner here. So do that, and it did it. Except I forgot I moved it from the middle. It's actually the middle of that particular quadrant. So that's why that's not doing that. But that explains how you can show a prop on one screen and not another, or show those two props, or three or four, whatever, on all screens if that's the way that you want to do it. So that's how you can do that in ProPresenter 7. If you like this content, I bet you'd like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course. So head on over to tdm.fyi/pro7quick. And give me your name and email address so I can make a login for you, and you can watch that at your leisure. Until next time, this is Paul Alan Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.